In this video, we will learn how to make some easy and quick gold from the chests in Biora Marshes. We will look at the paths together that will run through some chests and shouldn't take long at all to complete. The chests we will open are going to be the essence chests. They are going to be small, medium, and large. To be able to open all of the chests, you will need at least tier 2 in the resilience essence manipulation, valor essence manipulation, and vigilance essence manipulation. However, the large chests will give you better loot if you have the tier 3 essence manipulation. For example, to maximize your profit from a large vigilance essence chest, you will need the tier 3 in the vigilance essence manipulation, and so on. You will also sometimes find some of those chests hidden behind a barrier. To open that barrier, you will need to interact with the Raven Lock, and for that, you will need the Mastery, which is the first one, Raven Bond. Those chests can only be opened once per day per account, not per character. As we go, if you enjoyed the guide and found it useful, please consider subscribing and leaving a like, as this helps the channel and enables me to make more content. We will start our run from the Stillwater Speaking Waypoint, which is a little bit further into the map. At first, until you get familiar with the pass, it may take you a little bit of time, but once you get used to it and do it a few days, it will take you about 5-10 minutes to complete it maximum. Right now, I will show you the pass without stopping together. I would recommend getting the ones directly in your pass, especially the Eternal Ice Shards, which you are going to find very often, and you will even make more profit if you are going to use glyphs. As of right now, the volatile glyphs will be the most profitable. If you are not familiar with the glyphs or how they work, I have a guide that explains the system in details. I will leave the link for it in the comments and description. Also, please be aware that the small chests will have multiple possible locations to spawn at, but the medium and large will always have one location they will always be at. Our first location will be around the Ox Shrines. You will find the first small chest here in the water, or if it was not, you can take the Springer and then jump up, and you will either find it hidden behind those bushes or those bushes. After that, continue on your way. And you will find another small chest either here in the water, or above here, behind those rocks, or if it was not in either of those locations, you will see the third one as we go. Next, we will go up to the large and medium chests. You'll find the medium chest here, and then we go up for the large one. And you can either just take Griffin or Sky Scale to glide here, or if you don't, just take the Springer and then jump up again, and then we will go down to the chest. And then we can also walk a little bit further ahead, and we are going to see another known chest we can get. If you already found the other small chest we mentioned earlier, then you are done with this place. But if you are not, you can glide all the way from up here and go to the third possible location for the small chest we did not get earlier. Here is the third possible location for it. And then we continue gliding a little bit further to the tree, and you will find a known chest. And then we continue moving forward to get a couple more. Here you will find a medium and a known chest. They will be hidden behind this barrier. To open it, as we mentioned, just interact with the Raven lock that you will need the mastery for. It will open the barrier and you can get your chests. Next, we will need to go up for the next chest. And here is the large chest. Do keep in mind that jumping this last bit can be actually a little bit tricky. What you want to do is aim with your springer a little bit further away from the cliff, and then you can go up. Next, we will go to the ice spire peaks where we get more chests. So we can just glide all the way from here. And you will find the medium chest behind the barriers right here on the corner. And then we continue moving forward to get a couple more chests. Here is the first possible location for the small chest. If it was not here, it will be here. And if it was not here, you will find it on the corner. We continue moving forward after. And the first possible location will be here on the corner, or if it was not, you can go a little bit further and you can glide up the mountain here. And you will find it behind this idol, or if it was not, then it will be around the corner. Just keep looking around here, or if it was not, you will find it across. Now we are done with the north locations. Next, we will move south and we will go to Eagle Watch Rise. And for that, we will waypoint back to the Stillwater's waypoint and start moving south. We go all the way to the end and then we jump up. You will find the small chest here on the corner, or if it was not, it will be on the other side here. We'll continue moving forward after. And you will find the chest either here above this cliff, or if it was not, you will find it down here. We glide a little bit further and we will get another Norn chest on our way. And don't forget to gather on your way. And then we go to our last large chest. The large chest will be all the way up here. You will get a lot of loot by opening those chests, but the majority of your profit will come from the unidentified gear, eternal ice shards, aetherite ingots, and the materials you will collect as you gather. And on top of that, if you're using glyphs while gathering that gives you extra materials, like Watchwork Sprockets for example, or Fruitine Magic, then this will also be accounted for in your profit. I have a bunch of guides that explains how to maximize your profit from all of those. I will leave the links for them in the description, in the comments, and in your screen now. If you want to check more guides on how to make some gold in Guild Wars 2, I will leave the playlist on your screen now. Thank you very much for watching, and I will see you in the next guide.